as deep as my soul can reach, and as far as my eyes can see. With every breath that I breathe, and with every word that I speak,
good afternoon. What a joy it is to welcome you here to St. Mary Chapel, where we're going to watch a miracle. A man and a woman leave their lives behind, and through the sacrament of marriage, the two become one. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We have come rejoicing today in the house of the Lord for this celebration. Dear brothers and sisters, and now we stand with Peyton and Jonathan on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this has been a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and with our prayers as their brothers and sisters. Let us listen attentively with them to the word of God speaks to us today. Then with Holy Church, let us humbly pray to God the Father through Christ our Lord for this couple, his servants, that his lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. So let us pray. Be attentive to our prayer, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these your servants, Hayton and Jonathan, that coming together before you, before your altar, that they may be confident in you for your love for one another, for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to please be seated for our first reading that will be proclaimed by Tara.
A reading from Song of Songs. Hark, my lover, here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle, like a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the glasses. My lover speaks to me, he says, arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one. Oh, my dove, in the cleft of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you, let me hear your voice. For your voice is sweet and you are lovely. My lover belongs to me and I to him. He says to me, set me as a seal on your heart, as a seal on your arm. For stern as death is love, relentless as the never world is devotion. Its flames are blazing fire. Deep waters cannot quench love, nor floods sweep it away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. There was a wedding in Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washing, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them with water to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and when the people had drunk freely, an inferior one, but you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this at the beginning of his signs in Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. What a glorious day it is today to witness a wedding of a couple that you just look at them and you know they're in love with each other. Perfect together, right? Can the church say amen on that one?
Amen.
We agree. And I bet when you got their wedding invitation in the mail, I bet one word popped into your head, and that word is love. Like I said, you know them. You know how much they're in love with each other. And this day couldn't have come faster for them. But that word love, I believe when we say God, should pop into our head too. Because from the very beginning of time, God is having this ridiculous love affair with us. You know, we go back from the first book of the Bible, which is the book of Genesis, and God's love just continues to unfold on the pages, the very first pages of the Bible. First of all, like even man and woman, it wasn't good for man to be alone. So God created woman, his partner. And it was out of love for man that God created woman and gave them the dignity of children of God. And to show the incredible love that God has for us, and why it's so important today when God created us, he didn't create us with like robots. He created us with free will. And so our first parents had this gift of free will that we could freely return the love to God for all the love he has poured out to us. And that love and that free will is so important today. So when Jonathan and Peyton comes together, they're not coming out of course they're wired to say yes to each other. They're coming in freedom, and they're giving themselves freely to one another. But back to our first parents. We know because of that freedom that was given to them, they turned their back on God for some reason and ruptured our relationship with him. But from that moment of disobedience, God's love and intense love for all of us continued. And we know throughout the Old Testament, he raised up holy men and women to show us ways of love and righteousness. But sin became more and more prevalent. So God did the ultimate act of love. He sent his only son, Jesus Christ, into the world to die on the cross for us. And when Jesus died on the cross out of love for his church, he also gave us the best representation we have in the sacrament of marriage. You see, today the bridegroom, Jonathan, looks to his bride like Christ looked at his bride, the church, and says, "I love you so much that I will die for you, that nothing in the world is more important than you." And then the bride reciprocates in this love by saying to her spouse, "I love you and I'll do everything and raising our family with each other to get us all into heaven." It's a perfect union that Jesus showed us on the cross when he died out of love for his bride, the church. The best representation that we have, again, for marriage, is Jesus and his church. And so we know we are gathered here today in love. And like at the wedding at Cana that we just heard in the gospel, Jesus was there, the Blessed Mother, the disciples were there. They were here like us at a celebration, the invited guests. And all of us have a responsibility to the bride and groom, like Mary and the disciples had to the bride and groom in the wedding in Cana. And that is our promise to love them, to support them, to be there for them, but most importantly, to pray for them. For you who are married, you know, 25 years, 50 years, whatever, you could be the first to tell all of us that maybe things aren't as wonderful as on your wedding day. Maybe there'll be some bumps along the road. I'm sure a lot of you can attest to that. But it was the support of our prayers and our love for them that will sustain them, that today is the pinnacle of their love, but it's just the beginning. With our prayers, their love for each other will grow every single day. That's God's plan for marriage. Yes, there'll be bumps, but a life of prayer and our prayers and support for them will be there to help them and sustain them. So my brothers and sisters, better than any gift that you have for them for the reception is your promise to pray for them. There's supernatural grace in prayer. And this couple, and some of you will be here 50 years when they celebrate their golden jubilee. Of course, the power of Christ, who is the center of this covenant and showed us the sacrament of marriage and how to live and die for one another, is at the kernel, the corner of this sacrament that we celebrate today. So I invite the bride and groom now, if they would stand and let us all witness this beautiful sacrament of marriage. Dearly beloved, you have come here before a minister of the church in the presence of this community, so that your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal, and your love be enriched by his blessing, so that you may have the strength to be faithful to each other forever and to assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intention. Peyton and Jonathan, have you come here to enter into marriage freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the laws of Christ and his church?
I am.
Since this is your intention to enter into the covenant of matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. Jonathan, repeat it. I, Jonathan. Take you, Peyton. To be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you. In good times. And in bad. In sickness. And in health. To love you. And to honor you. All the days of my life.
I, Peyton.
Take you, Jonathan.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you. And honor you. All the days of my life.
May
the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessings within you. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. And Jonathan, if you take Peyton's ring, placing it on your finger, repeat after me. Peyton.
Receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Jonathan.
Jonathan,
take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Jonathan, you may kiss your bride. Isn't that wonderful? Oh my goodness. Well, I invite everybody to stand now for the prayer of the faithful. And I'd like to invite Tara to come up.
We lift up our voices in prayer as we ask God our Father to bless Peyton and Jonathan with peace, joy, and happiness as they begin to do life together.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. My bad. For the church and all its faithful, that we remain true to her teachings, grow deeper in faith, and be true reflections of God's love in the world each day, we pray. For Peyton and Jonathan, that their lives are filled with joy, and that their home, the home they create together, be graced with friendship, laughter, and love. That the love of Peyton and Jonathan share always be patient and ready to trust and endure whatever comes their way. And that they always give thanks for the gift of each other, we pray. That the love of Peyton and Jonathan have for each other be a grateful reminder of the love they have received from their families. That in marriage, Peyton and Jonathan give and be able to forgive and find happiness in each passing day, we pray. For their parents who gave them life in the beginning, may they receive God's abundant blessings for the love, care, and concern, guidance, support, and understanding they have given their children throughout their lives, we pray. For the deceased members of the families, especially the grandparents, Edward and Elise Stover, Alfonso, and Joseph Palillo, who watch over us from on high, we pray. For all those who serve in our armed forces, that they may be kept safe from harm, as they bravely protect and defend our nation, we pray.
Lord, through your Holy Spirit, you have blessed us with the ability to love. Grant the generous increase in this gift to Peyton Jonathan and their family and friends. Let them always be known by their love and their generous spirit. This we ask for Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for all.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accepts the sacrifice.
Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you, and in your fatherly love, watch over those you have joined in a sacramental covenant. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Give thanks and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised in such a high dignity that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love. For those you have created out of charity, you call into the Lord charity, without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity. And so the sacrament of holy matrimony, as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrated the love of man and woman through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. I invite you to please kneel and be seated.
Right there.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them, that they may become for us the body and soul of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of its death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Of all Holy Spirit, glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At this point of our liturgy, we will now bestow upon the couple a nuptial blessing. Holy Father, who formed man in your own image, male and female you created them, so that as husband and wife, united in bond and body and heart, they might fulfill the calling of the world. O God, who, to reveal your great design, you formed in your love, willed that your love of spouse for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand over these your servants, Peyton and Jonathan. We pray and outpour in their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that as they enter upon the sacramental union, they may share with one another the gifts of your love, and by being for each other a sign of your presence, become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deed, the home they are forming to prepare their children to welcome members of your heavenly household by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown with your blessing your daughter Peyton, so that by being a good wife and mother, she may bring warmth to her home with the love that is pure and adored with the welcoming graciousness. Bestow heavenly blessings also, O Lord, on Jonathan, your servant, that he may be a worthy, good, and faithful husband and provident father. Grant, O Lord, that desiring to approach your table as a joined couple in marriage in your presence, they may one day have the joy of taking part in the great banquet of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away sins of the world. Blessed are those souls who have suffered the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul. Having been partakers of your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may also hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before our final blessing, again, what I honor you, first of all, to be here at the wedding. You play such an important part as witnesses. And as I asked during the homily to continue to pray for this couple as your gift to them, remember what I said, you know, this isn't the pinnacle of their love. This is really just the springboard, the start of the increase of their love. And so with our prayers, they will continue to grow in love with Jesus and with each other every single day in their married lives. And there's no better gift than that. So let us really, truly promise them. And I just want to say what a joy it has been to prepare this couple for this day. You know they love each other. And that's the gospel the world needs to hear today and witness to, is the love of Jesus Christ. And so the Lord be with you.
Oh, your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart and love in one another for the peace of Christ. May dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen.
Amen.
May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen.
Amen.
May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Go forth, celebration is ended. Thanks be to God.
Half dust on my boots, a thousand cathedrals, I have taken my place. I have raised my voice with a multitude of angels whose nests are treasured by your trees. Music on your feet.
You look at me, babe, I wanna catch on fire. It's buried in my soul, like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up but I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Lovers in the night, though it's trying to ride. We don't know how to rhyme, but damn, we try. But all I really know, you're where I wanna go. The part of me that's you will never die. So when I'm all choked up and I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Oh yeah, I don't wanna be just a memory, baby.
She's gotta do what she's gotta do, and I've gotta like it or not. She's got dreams too big for this town, and she needs to give them a shot, wherever they are. Gotta be strong.
I've said so many things to you for so many times on how beautiful you are and how special you are and how hard it is for Dad and I to let you leave. But today, seeing you with John, I know it's the right decision, and I know you're going to be very happy, and you always have us. always, all of you. You and John and whatever babies you want to bring into this. Love you.
When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care and nothing is going right. Close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. Just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall,
if we just, we could just pause for a second and just put ourselves in the presence of God. Dear God, we ask you to bless Peyton and Jonathan in a very special way this evening. We ask that you give them every blessing and every joy for the rest of their life. We ask you also to bless the food we're about to eat, the hands that prepared it, and the hands that serve it. We also like to take a moment of silence just to remember those people, family members and friends that are not here with us physically, but certainly here spiritually tonight. We ask you this always in the God of our choice.
How's everyone doing tonight? All right, so my name is James. I'm John's best man. And I'd like to start off. My name is James. I am John's best man, and I'd like to start off with how we met. John and I met in second grade, and when we first met, we didn't really hit things off that well. John was a bit of a bully. He loved stealing my toys at recess, or you know, just causing some trouble. And I know Mrs. Alfano, you can attest to that. We were able to put all that behind us, and you know. Years later, obviously, we were able to grow to become very good friends. Throughout the years, I have learned many things from John, as we've always been able to compliment each other. Whether it was on the field in soccer, pushing each other to run faster on runs, or me asking him for help at work for some Marine Corps-related tasks. One of my favorite things about my friendship with John is even though we're about 2,000 to 3,000 miles away, and we're working in different time zones, and we won't speak for sometimes weeks on end. Whenever I can reach out to him, we're always able to pick up right where we left off. There have been times where I've needed someone to talk to just to get away from stress, and John would always be that person who I can rely on. He is the shoulder I lean on, and he will always be a brother to me. Whether we are playing video games, working out at the butt crack of dawn, or drinking until we slur our words, John was and will always be the friend to accompany me. When John and I were in high school, I found out he was dating a girl, which obviously happened to be Peyton. I was shocked because I didn't really know John talked to girls, let alone... Thank you. Let alone with day one. But when I did find out it was Peyton, I was excited for him. Peyton and I had met in freshman year Spanish class. When I met her, she was a very kind-hearted girl, very, very nice, but she was failing one of the easiest Spanish classes you could imagine. Jokes aside, Peyton is an anchor for John. She has helped him mature into an amazing man since the day they started dating. She is the one person John can tell everything to without judgment and will provide him with the best advice to get him through. John, Peyton, I'm excited for you both to start a new life together as husband and wife. Your relationship has been through thick and thin, battling the hardships that come with the Marine Corps. No contact at boot camp, 2,000 miles of separation, and, you know, seeing each other maybe 2 or 3 weeks a year. You were able to withstand anything the world threw at you, which was a testament for your love. Now those hardships are over, and you have the rest of your lives to spend with each other. Lastly, I want to thank the families here today. I also want to thank Mr. and Mrs. Alfano and Mr. and Mrs. Bellillo. Without you guys, we would not be here celebrating today. I am honored to be a part of this celebration of John and Peyton, man and woman, bride and groom. If everyone could please raise their glasses, as I'd like to give a toast to John and Peyton.
Wow, that's a tough speech to follow. I'm a little nervous, so just bear with me. So thank you all for coming here to celebrate Peyton and John's special day. For those of you who I haven't had a chance to meet yet, my name is Aline. I'm Peyton's maid of honor. We've been best friends for about 16 years now. Peyton and I have been friends for a while. It all started out in first grade. It was my first day of first grade. I just moved here from Switzerland. Didn't speak a word of English. Very, very nervous. About as nervous as I am now, not gonna lie. But at least I know what everyone's saying. So Peyton insisted on being my best friend. She went up to the teacher and she told her, I want to be friends with this girl. And the teacher tried to explain to her, it's not that easy. She doesn't understand you. But Peyton didn't take no for an answer. And as we can now see, when you put your mind to something, you can achieve anything. Because I'm living proof. Here we are, maid of honor, giving a speech at her wedding. Since that first day, we've been through it all, the good and the bad, from my move back to Switzerland to boyfriends, husbands, enlisting in the Marines. You know how to keep things interesting and are always someone I can count on for a good laugh. The first time you came to Switzerland, I actually took you on a toboggan ride. I hope everyone knows what that is. It's those little sleds and like those metal things. I mean, I was pretty sure they were Peyton safe, considering I've never in my life seen someone get hurt on one of these things. You know, we know Peyton. So 2 minutes into the ride, she's in the cart in front of me and I see her flying out of that cart into the grass. And I was like, how is this possible? So thank God, besides a couple of scrapes and bruises, I think she still has a couple of scars to prove it. She was fine. So even though that you are a little clumsy, you have happened to stumble into a very loving relationship with a husband who loves you the way you deserve to be loved. You have been my rock, my fourth sister, my best friend, and you deserve all the happiness in the world. John, you're one lucky guy. Unfortunately, I've only had the pleasure of seeing you a couple of times, but that was enough for me to see how happy you make Peyton. You are a supportive, understanding, and a caring person. I actually trust him enough that I didn't have to threaten him by saying, you know, if you hurt her, you'll have me to deal with. I mean, I did threaten him. I just didn't have to. I assume you must also be pretty patient. I mean, you've been able to put up with her for the past 5 years, so hats off. As a couple, you've had challenges thrown your way, but you worked through it and it only made you stronger. You have come so far, and today, here we are on your wedding day, celebrating the two of you. I would like to thank everyone who helped plan and make this day so very special. Allison and Olivia, a special thanks to you. You guys took on maid of honor duties without hesitation and did things that I couldn't take care of from overseas. So big thanks to you guys. Lenore and Joe, my second parents, having spent the last three weeks with you, I've come to the realization that there's more to planning a wedding than booking a venue and getting a white dress. So I know how much effort and work went into this special day and everything looks amazing. You really outdid yourself. So big thanks to you guys. So according to Wikipedia how-to, this is the part of the speech where I'm supposed to give some advice, but I'm 23 single and will probably end up with 10 cats. So I really don't know what to tell you. I mean, I can tell you, you know, good luck with this whole marriage thing. John, never forget the two most important replies. You're right, my dear. And okay, just buy it. So here's to the husband. Here's to the wife. May they remain lovers for life. Cheers.
First, I'd like to thank everyone for coming out and celebrating this wonderful day with all of us. It's a pleasure to have everyone. Thank you. September 4th, 2000. That's Peyton's birthday. That's the first child we had. Also the most memorable time in my life. Three characteristics about Peyton jump off the chart to me. One, she's independent. She's really her own person. Two, oh, let me take that back. She gets that from her mother, without a doubt. Number two, she's one of the most caring and kindest persons I've ever met. She gets that from her grandma Diane and her grandma Pat. And number three, she has a knack for being very silly. I'm talking cringeworthy. This guy right here. May 19th, 2019. That was the day John got on the bus to go to boot camp. Boot camp, or the Marines, I should say, is not something you wake up and say, I'm going to join the Marines. That's something you put some thought into. There's usually a purpose. I have a feeling the purpose is sitting next to you. I love you both. I'll be there for you both. And I'd like to make a toast. May your love be as modern to survive the times. Oh, sorry. And last long enough for the rest of your life.
Each night I ask the stars up above, why must there be a teenager in love? I cry, dear, nobody but you. I'll be a lonely one if you should stay there through. Well, if you want to make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. And if you should say goodbye, I still go on loving you. Each night I ask the stars up above, why must that be a teenager in love? I got a dear, nobody but you. I'll be a lonely one if you should stay with me. Well, if you want to make me cry, that won't be so hard to do. And if you should say goodbye, I'll still go on loving you. Each night I ask the stars up above, why must there be a teenager in love? Why must there be a teenager in love? I hope.
Thank you.